Good morning, children. How are you all? I hope you all are fit and fine. So, children, today we are going to start a new chapter, chapter number 5, Morphology of Flowering Plants. So, children, first we should know about the morphology. Morphology means the study of the external forms of the organism. For example, for animals and the plants, both. Logy means study and morpho means external appearance. So this is the external appearance or external form of the any living microbes, living plant or the animals. So children, the angiosperms, we have discussed in the previous chapter about the angiosperm, that are the flowering plants and characterized by the presence of roots, stems, leaves, flowers and the fruits. So children, in this chapter we will discuss about the flower and the inflorescence and only one family related to our practical course, which is the Solanaceae. So children, the flower and the inflorescence. Main, the flower means the modified shoot, wherein the shoot apical meristem changes to floral meristem and the internodes do not elongate and the axis gets condensed so that the apex produces the various floral appendages laterally at the successive nodes instead of the leaves. And when a shoot tip transforms into a flower, it is the solitary. So children, the arrangement of the cluster of the flowers on the floral axis is called the inflorescence, and it is based on whether the apex gets converted into a flower or continues to grow. So that it is mainly two types. First is racemose and second is cymose. So children, in the racemose, this is the main axis continues to grow and the flowers are born laterally in a acropetal succession. And the cymose, the main axis terminates in a flower. You can see in this picture, children, cymose is terminate in a flower and hence is limited in the growth, so that the flowers are born in the basipetal orders. So children, in this diagram you can see the acropetal and the basipetal also. So children, the reproductive unit in the angiosperm is the flower. It is meant for the sexual reproduction. And the flower has a pedicle. It is the swallow end is called the thalamus part. And the reduced leaf found at the base of the pedicle is called the bracts. So that the flowers with the bracts are called the bracteate. And those without bracts are called the ebracteate. So children, mainly there are four whorls arranged on the thalamus. First is the calyx, second is corolla, third is androecium and the fourth is gynoecium. The calyx and the corolla is called the accessory organs and the androecium and the gynoecium are called the reproductive organs. You can see in this picture the reproductive organs and the accessory organs. First is calyx, then corolla, then androecium, then gynoecium. So children, in some flowers like the lily, the calyx and corolla are not distinct and it is termed as the perianth. When a flower has both androecium and the gynoecium, so that it is called the bisexual flower. But a flower having either only androecium or only gynoecium, so that it is called the unisexual flower. So hope children, this topic is clear. Any query you can write in query box. Today's your homework is to draw a well-labeled diagram of the flower and the inflorescence, cymose and racemose type of inflorescence in your notebook. Thank you, children.